Hello everyone. In this session, we are going to start studying the surface mounting components. So far, we have been designing the PCBs. We have created a single-sided PCB design. We have created a double-sided PCB design, as well as we have seen how to create ground plane in a PCB. From this session and on, we are going to study the PCB design in a little bit complex way by adding SMD components to it. SMD components stands for surface mounting devices or surface mounting technology also. So let's begin. What is exactly the SMT, that is surface mounted technology? It is a technique of connecting socket components to a PCB track, where the solder joint forms using a pad onto the PCB and the metal pin of the component. So in usual cases where the holes are created onto the PCB, in SMT, the pads are created and the copper is connected to these pads. So there is no hole used in while making this connection. As you can see here into this photograph, we can see that the IC pad and the PCB pad gets connected to each other with the solder joints. So there is no hole involved in this SMT component. If you can see, this is the surface mount component versus these are the through hole components. For through hole components, there has to be a hole onto the PCB. Components mount from one side and get soldered on the opposite side. Whereas in surface mount, the component mounting and soldering happens onto the same side. It simply means that on the PCB, the component mounting and soldering happens on the same layer of the PCB. So either the components can be on the top copper layer or can be on the bottom copper layer. Wherever the component is, it will be soldered at the same layer. So why we need it? Why we actually use this kind of components? Through hole components are very easy to mount onto the PCB, but they are, or they usually take more space, and sometimes they are also more costly. SMT components uses pads to mount on the circuit board. They are very simple, they are difficult to hand solder, but usually they take a very less space. And if you see pricing wise, then many times we find that the SMT components are cheaper than their through hole counterparts. So almost all the parts which are available as through hole are also available as surface mounting device, like ICs, capacitors, resistors, inductors, LEDs, connectors, and many more. What we have to do is we have to check for the data sheet for the part if its surface mounting device is available or not. The most important reason why SMD is used is because SMDs are smaller, faster to create the PCB, and they are cheaper in many sense. It saves the space of the PCB and thereby also saves the PCB cost. One more reason for using SMD is many new components like accelerometers, some specific microcontrollers, some sensors are only available in the surface mount package. So they are not available in the through hole package at all. So that's why study of the SMD is empirical and most important when we are studying the PCB designing. Now, we'll have to see what are the PCB footprints of the most commonly used components so that we would be able to create a PCB for it. So here is the PCB footprint of a resistor. A through hole resistor has two different holes and is placed quite at a distance from each other. Whereas a through hole resistor looks like this, an SMT resistor looks like this, which has pads on the two sides, which can be placed onto the board, and this contact area gets soldered to the board. The resistor looks like this, which is printed with a code for that resistor's value. And the package is like this. So package is the PCB's, the component's width compared to its length. So the common package are 0603, 0805 and 1206. In 0603 package, or in say 1206 package, which I prefer on creating my PCBs, 12 stands for the length of the component and 06 stands for the width of the component. So in 1206, the length is 0.12 inch and the width is 0.06 inch. In the same way, 0805 has 0.08 inch of length and 0.05 inch of width. So these codes specify the size of your SMD component. I use 1206 because they are sufficiently bigger, easier to hold in the tweezer, and we can easily solder them. But usually 06, 0, and there are many such packages which are used. So not only these three, but there are many such packages which is given in the resources of this video. The resistors look like this and the capacitors will usually look like this. You can mount them in both the sides, but resistors are mounted in such a way that the value is seen from the above. There is no code on the capacitor, so capacitor can be mounted in either direction, either orientation. Diodes and transistors usually share the same package, which is SOT23. Of course, this is not the truth always, but SOT23 is famous for diodes as well as transistors. An SOT23 diode like BAL99 looks like this, and its pads are spaced like this, and this is how the pins are arranged. An SOT23 transistor like BC857 looks like this, and these are its components. So this common pin or this pin is the collector, this two number is emitter, and this one number is base of transistor. Based upon which component you are using, the data sheet is the best resource to identify what package is available. So here this SOT23 is the name of the package which we are using for transistor or diode. Here this is 0603, 0805 or 1206 are the package codes. These are default package codes and are present in every CAD software, PCB design software you will ever encounter. For ICs, there are a variety of different packages available. We are going to see the most important ones, and as said, you have to see the data sheet for the respective packages or PCB footprints of the SMD ICs you are using. Most commonly, this SO8 package is famous for all the 8-pin ICs. Usually all the 8-pin ICs comes in SO8 package. This is DS1307 real-time clock. If I am taking a 555 IC in SMD package, it will also come in the similar shape. This is TQFP44 package, which is for the Atmega 32U4 IC. SSOP28 for the FT232 IC, which is USB to serial converter, USB to UART converter. This is CP2102, which is also USB to UART converter, which comes in 28-pin MLP connector. So these are different packages of different ICs. The resources of or the resources file of this video will tell you about the number of different packages of number of different ICs available with their name and their footprints. So what we are going to do with these packages and what we are going to do with this surface mounting components is we are going to create a project out of it. This will be a big project which involves double-sided design as well as which also involves the placement of surface mounting components. As a general rule, through-hole components are placed all on the same side on PCBs, whereas SMDs based on the requirement can be placed on both the side of the board. The project that we are going to do is a FT232 based USB to TTL converter. So this is the project which we are going to do, which involves an IC, some resistors, capacitors and LEDs present in surface mounting package, a USB connector as well. So we have to create this PCB in as small size as possible. We have to use all the resources like SMD devices as well as single-sided and double-sided PCB design technique and create this project. This file is separately also given into the resources section. These are the packages we are going to need when creating this design. In next session, we will design this schematic of it and then artwork and layout for the same project. I hope you would find it simple to do this designing using the single-sided as well as double-sided PCB and using the surface mounting components. So I hope you will enjoy these sessions. Thanks for watching.